Kelvin, let's talk about what you've been doing so far this week. Yesterday was your first trip to Cowboys Stadium. What was that like when you first walked in there?
Crazy. I mean, I've heard about it. A lot of my friends, they play in the NFL. They have played there. They told me about it. But you never know what to expect. I mean, and when I walked in there, it exceeded all my expectations. When we kind of got off the exit and I saw it, my eyes just lit up. I was like, man, it's going to be fun. And then when we actually went through the door, it was just crazy. I mean, obviously the first thing you see is the big screen. And I'm glad that we got to practice in there and things. So, because I had to hate to be the guy going in there on Friday for the first time and catching myself like that in the middle of the game. So, I mean, it's going to be fun. I'm excited to be here.
Now, did you guys come down the highway and see how far you were when you first bought the stadium?
Yeah.
That's always cool. You know, you first drive, you're like, wow, what is that? Let's talk about the season you guys had this year. As always, SEC, tough. I mean, great defenses all around. Tell me a little bit about your season.
Oh, it's been great. Of course, not perfect, but when is it ever perfect? It's very rarely that you have a perfect season. But it's been great. The experiences I've had, I can't complain one bit. I love our position. I love where we're at. Although we have two losses, those games were heartbreaking and things like that. But I've enjoyed the experiences. We started off, we kind of know, because we had a lot of young guys coming in, having tremendous impact. And as the season grew on, the chemistry grew stronger and stronger and stronger. And the ball just kept rolling. And, you know, we had some close calls, some close games where things could have went either way. And most of the time it went all the way. So I can't complain. I just enjoyed it and had fun with it.
Let's talk about Texas A&M. You guys are looking at an offense that had transition in the middle of the year where they moved from Gerard Johnson to Ryan Tannehill. So let's talk a little bit about Ryan Tannehill. Tell us about some of the intangibles that he has as you're watching the film, the things you've got to really watch out for this guy.
I think a lot of people, and what I try to remind my teammates, especially the defense, about is his speed. Because a lot of people might get deceived by his speed. He is an ex-receiver and was playing receiver actually this year. So, I mean, just all his intangibles. Like you said, he's a great game manager. He rarely makes mistakes. And him being an ex-receiver, he knows the routes. He knows how the receiver is supposed to come out of the route. So that allows him to get the ball there on time. And that minimizes his sacks and also his interceptions. And he manages one of the top offenses in the country right now. And since he's took over, they're 6-0. And in my opinion, I can honestly say I believe they're the strongest team in the Big 12 right now.
You know, a lot of people talk about that and their running game.
Right.
But what a lot of people fail to forget is the two great receivers they had.
Definitely.
Talk to us about that. Because that's something even as a middle linebacker, you've got to work.
Oh, yeah, that's because they could easily put him at the number three receiver, and that'll match up with me, and I'll be out there against some of the best. And, I mean, they just do a great job. And I think he all evolves and goes back to the quarterback. He does a great job managing. I think he understands the scheme, and he knows the guys that he have around him, and he makes sure he gets the ball in their hands.
Let's talk about Friday night's game, only game on TV, the only game in town. It's going to be your last game with LSU.
All right.
Your coach labeled this yesterday the greatest stadium in the universe. Talk about your feelings leading up to that. What do you think is going to be going through your head other than getting, you know, Texas A&M? But, you know, there's got to be a lot of emotions there.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I can't even imagine. I'm a pretty vulgar guy. My teammates tell you I'm pretty vocal, pretty emotional. I get into the game. I love football. It's who I am, really. And this being my last game as LSU Tiger, that's where I spent the last 5 years of my life. I've grown to love it. I've grown to become a Tiger at heart. You see my hair, the gold, I love it. And I'm sure this is going to be bittersweet, but I've enjoyed it. And if I had to do it all over again, this is exactly how I wanted it to happen.